So sleep is a very complicated topic because everybody may have problems sleeping, but it's for a myriad of different reasons. It could be medical reasons, could be just, you know, maladaptive behaviors. But what the point I want to make is that sleep and the immune system are intimately connected. We know for a fact that people who get more sleep before they get an immunization have a better immune response with higher antibody titers to, for instance, the flu vaccine. We know that when people are challenged with a virus, they actually did this study where they put rhinovirus into students' noses, subjects' noses on purpose. You know, living on a college campus, people will do any study for for very little money. So it's easy to get those kind of students. But this is what they did. They subjected them to rhinovirus, and they put it into their nose, and they waited to see how many people came down with the common cold. And when they looked back and saw what their sleep habits were, it was a 5 to 7-fold difference if you looked at those people that got 7 or more hours of sleep per night versus those that got less, and whether or not they had a good sleep efficiency. So sleep efficiency is how many hours you're actually sleeping divided by the number of hours that you're in bed. And so you have good sleep efficiency, you've got good hours of sleep, so good quality, good quantity. Your risk of getting any kind of virus, like a rhinovirus, adenovirus, those sorts of things, is cut by 5 to 7-fold. That's a massive number when you consider what we're trying to do to reduce the incidence of COVID-19 right now with vaccinations and things of that nature. That just a good night's sleep can have that much of an impact. It's not a cure, but it certainly is somewhere to start.